I'd also like to say a few words about what is going on at the national level, the politics that is taking place, and the state of our country. Our country is a country of many religions, and I have not come across a single religion that preaches hatred, anger, and violence. What is going on at the
unfortunately
national, there is a tendency among those who rule us in Delhi to divide this country along religious lines, to divide this country along community lines, and to use violence to solve problems. I personally do not believe that violence can solve any problem. I've been a victim of violence in my life. I've lost my father, my grandmother to violence, and as somebody who has experienced violence firsthand, I know that it does not solve anything. And you certainly cannot run a country on the principle of violence. And you can see the result. There is fear in the country today. Atrocity is taking place against women. Every day you read in the newspaper, a girl is raped, people are beaten up, somebody is thrashed, and it is because the ideology that is running India today is based on division and violence. And so, as Indians, we have to bring this nation together. And I'm talking especially to the youngsters who are standing here. It is your duty more than anybody else's. When people use division, when people use hatred, when people use anger, it is your duty to tell them that that is not Indian culture, that is not Indian tradition, and that is not preached by any single religion on this earth. And the result of this cult of violence, the result of this division, is visible in many different spheres. You remember that India was known as being one of the fastest growing economies in the world. We used to grow at 9%. Today we are growing at 4%, and we are growing at 4% according to the new method of calculating GDP. If you actually calculate according to the old method, India's economic growth today is 2.5%. So it is actually a disaster. And it's a tragedy because these young ladies here who are looking forward to getting a job, who are looking forward to helping this country grow, are going to find it difficult in the current environment to get a job. The highest unemployment in 45 years, that is the situation in India. And the simple answer is a divided country. A country that is fighting within itself, among itself, a country that is not united and not working together. And that is what I think all of us have to change. It impacts everything. It impacts agriculture. It impacts small business. It impacts big business. And the central reason is the philosophy of divide and rule division. And I really appreciate Wayanad and Kerala, because you're in the forefront of proving to the rest of the country that multiple religions, multiple ideas can live together, prosper together, and succeed together. So I wish all the best to this hospital. I am confident that you will grow, you will continue to grow, you will continue to expand, and your work will be appreciated by many, many, many people. Thank you very much. All the best.